pelters of the puppets of Pakistan trying to disrupt peace. There is not a single casualty which has happened in the last 30 days. And this is the most calmest period in the history of Kashmir, if I can say that. Calmest and the most peaceful 30 days from the point of view of civilian deaths by the security forces or anyone other things. All the deaths which have happened by terrorists or the stone pelters. Now you can make out who is disrupting peace in the valley, who is not happy with the peace in the valley. So now coming to the point about infiltration, the question which was addressed to me. Infiltration, like I said earlier, the infiltration attempts are being done every night, not only on Kashmir frontier or the Kashmir line of control, but also in the Rajouri to Punch, Jammu, as also the IB sector going right up to Pathankot and borders of Punjab and Gujarat, as also the other routes which are available through third countries. Notwithstanding that, all the infiltration bids are being encountered on the line of control. As of now, the information available with us from the hinterland, there is not a single infiltration attempt which has been successful in Kashmir Valley, and this I can assure you. Coming to the infiltration thing, like I said, ask me in any language. If I understand, I will reply in that language. I know 7 languages, otherwise I'll Google it and answer your question. The answer is going to be same. Answer is, Pakistan is attempting infiltrations every night. We are encountering infiltrations on the line of control every night. Some of them are getting eliminated, some of them are getting foiled, and they are returning back to the Pakistani army posts from where they were launched. So numbers, I am not a numbers man, but I am telling you they are full and they are wanting to infiltrate in major quantities or major numbers. Now coming to this rumors. Gentlemen and ladies, I have visited Gulmarg sector at least in the last 15 days, I think more than 5-6 times. There are more than 350 operations which have been launched around Gulmarg, including some specific information searches inside Gulmarg town. Otherwise, as you are aware, Gulmarg has been terrorism-free area because of the tourism and other things. But in this last 15-20 days, wherever we got the information, either on the speculation or even the rumors which you are also listening, not a single thing has happened in Gulmarg, whatever is coming in the news, I can confirm to you. I would request any one of you who wants to visit Gulmarg, I will facilitate your move. Please go and stay in Gulmarg, wherever you want to visit, whichever place you want to visit. Please report from any place in Gulmarg. And whatever your rumors are, whatever you are hearing, they will absolutely get addressed.
Sir, if I may just please.
See, my teacher, primary teacher told me, when someone is talking, don't interrupt.
Okay.
I'm sure. Huh? Okay. So I would once again request you to please come to Gulmarg. See for yourself. Report from wherever you want. We will facilitate your movement. We will facilitate any way you want to go in Gulmarg. As you are aware, immediately after Balakot strikes, unprovoked ceasefire violation was undertaken by Pakistan Army on 12th of March, which was befittingly replied to. Thereafter, he kept quiet. Then on 30th of July, as again you are aware, from 12th of March to 30th of July, there were no major ceasefire violations. But on 30th July, again the unprovoked RT and air defense guns were fired, for which we raised the hotline message with the DGMO of Pakistan. But then we reserved the right to respond. This is also was told to the DGMO of Pakistan, and we did respond. And we responded very well on the targets from where the fire came from. Thereafterwards, post 5th of August, there have been 3-4 instances of ceasefire violation, including one in Gurez sector, where because of RT shelling of Pakistan, 2 villages were injured and 8 to 10 houses were gutted and they were burnt. So adequate compensation has been given to them. And this brings me back to the point that Pakistan Army is also targeting the villages and the civilian areas on the line of control side. And just to add a point, so that you know, this press conference might be heard by a lot of people of Kashmir also. Immediate action was taken by the civil administration. The DC Saab was there the next day. He gave immediate on-the-spot compensation, as also worth about 76 crores of underground bunkers for the villages in the vicinity of the line of control to protect them from the shelling by Pakistan Army against innocent civilians, their livestock and their property. This was sanctioned and the work is in progress. This is just an additional information since you asked the question on firing on the line of control. Thank you.
Sir, can I mention again, sir? Can I mention again?
See, these are operational details. I can tell you one thing, no attempt whatsoever, whether bat action or infiltration, has been successful. They have been eliminated before they came anywhere close to the ambushes or the posts of Indian Army. And a point about the Gulmarg thing, this number of ambushes, which I said more than 350 of operations, it also includes on the line of control in which, one out of which, these two terrorists were also apprehended. So it's an overall in that sector, the numbers which I gave. These terrorists, the two LET terrorists, jiska humne video bhi dikhaya, they were arrested in Gulmarg sector. And now that the question has come, I would like to just show you a Google map. Can we have it if we have the? Okay. Okay, now gentlemen, this is the area of Hajipir Pass. This is the Shamshabari going, Pir Panjal going. And this is the area of Hilan Makhni Baul, which is in the illegal occupation of Pakistan, in the Pakistan illegally occupied Kashmir. And this is where the Bata Hilan and the launch pad and the army, Pakistan army posts were there from where they were launched. And they were coming towards the area of Afrawat, which is also happened to be on the Pir Panjal, on the boundary between 15 core and 16 core. So overall, this area falls under the Gulmarg sector, as we call it. Thank you. As you are all aware, for last 30 years, Army has been involved in a lot of Sadbhavna activities, lot of interaction with the opinion makers, the Maulvis, the teachers, the students, the sarpanches, for the benefit of the area, as also to get from them what is required for the development of the area in terms of infrastructure, girls' schools, the degree colleges, the roads, the culverts. This time, in fact, we have already submitted a short-term and long-term projects to the government, taken from the villagers through the company operating basis and compiled them and given to the government that these are the aspirations of the local population at the grassroots level. And the civil administration is taking those into consideration and cognizance. So we have been interacting with the awam. Like I always say, hum log hum saya hain. Din raat kathe rehte hain. Raat ke 2 baje, again my primary teacher told me, not to interrupt, I'm sure yours would have also told you. Okay. So hum log raat din kathe rehte hain. Unki takleef humari takleef hai. Agar raat ke 2 baje bhi koi aake darwaja khatkhataata hai medical help ke liye or for anything, it is done. Now coming specifically to your point of Maulvis being told and all those things, see what is happening is there are narratives being spread by Pakistan and there are some clarification which people come to seek from you. They feel this man is an educated man, he is a postgraduate, he is a person who has been commissioned into the army post the psychological analysis and other things, and he is probably aware as to what are the things to be there. So this is a normal doubt clearance sessions, which even you can sit with me and I can sit with you. If I don't know something about, like I am telling you, I am in Kashmir for last 31 years. Few things about 370, which was my subject for last 31 years, few things I also came to know post 5th of August. So it is but natural people have doubts. If someone has come to someone or someone has been talking to other person, it is a normal conversation which happens in, amongst two individuals and adults. So there is nothing wrong in it and there is no organized.